What do you mean do what? You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I know full well, but it's not happening.
Are you mad or something? You come all the way here to tell me that? Your friend's over there doing the mad thing.
Yeah, that's mad.
So what? You come here just to sit, stand around and just what? Look at me in my face?
Yeah.
You know what time it is when you come down to link the man there?
No.
What do you mean no?
If I don't want to, I don't
you're dressed up and nowhere to go. You know what time it is already if you're coming on the
block. It's New Year's Eve. I should be clubbing.
Thank you. Summer that followed was a mixture of fun and crazy hat. I was still playing football, but spent most of my time hanging with the Holly Street Boys on the estate late into the night. As it was summer, the rave scene was popping, with a lot of shows for the under-18s. Sometimes, me, Giza and the other boys from Holly Street would rave at Cheeky B's, our weekly spot in Hackney. Anytime we heard there was a shows in the ends, we'd gatecrash it. Then there were the raves which you couldn't miss, if you wanted to feel like you were somebody big. Raves where Heartless Crew used to MC and DJ. They mainly played garage along with Bashman, R&B and that touch of jungle. For most kids, summer was about having fun, but on my estate, that fun was always interrupted by some sort of drama. personally saw it as a way of showing love for keeping it real. From all peeps on the street, when someone had your back, it created a silent special bond. For some of us, that bond was like a life insurance policy. And even though we became tight, I still wasn't 100% certain that they had my back to the end. I couldn't tell who was real and who wasn't. When it came down to it, I realised that the only person I could depend on 100% to be was me. Trust is a luxury I can't afford. Betrayal is something I can't ignore. If I'm honest, I didn't even know what the full meaning of keeping it real was anymore. I assumed it meant always backing the man them's beat. Never snitch, never touch a bridge's wifey, and never snake man. I couldn't understand why most of the man them I parred with found it so hard to maintain these simple guidelines. It's not like Holly Street Boys was pussy. Not even. It's just that they got shook to back beef whenever we were outnumbered or the other team had holders. We never had no holders back in us. They all went when their flats got knocked down. At this time, I found a lot of realness and comfort in listening to one NY rapper called Omega. His tunes had me in a zone, especially when I had a split to hand. My favourite album this time had to be called Omega The Realness. I could listen to that album from the first track all the way through. The interlude alone had me pulling up the track over and over. Yo, what you doing, niggas? You know what I'm saying? You gotta know where they stand. Watch this. Cause everyone is your man when things is getting right. Oh, but what about when things is getting wrong? Then the first verse, killed it. Ask yourself, am I your man? Would I die for you or by your hand? If I go broke, would you devise your grants? Put me in your plans. Hold me down with your heat if my shit jams. And then the chorus said, ooh, if I died, would you cry? Need, would you provide? If I got beef, would you be squeezing side by side? If I face time, would you give me a place to hide? Would you stay me for paper? Look in my eyes.
She even takes life. I sneak her into clubs and wind her down nicely. Because I keep her so close that other thugs don't like me. She let off cause a boy stepped on my Adidas shells. The force of a chrome dress made my dick rise. I called again, this time got picked up by a guy. I said, yo, she loves me and she hugs me, and she loves my new size. See, me and her together, we're some real trendsetters. I used to go to clubs, pull her out, no ID. And there's other people out there that wanna be just like me. See, I'm lost and confused, brother, so why be me? Imagine it started off with 18, Mr. T. I used to wanna be a bad guy, dreams of a G. And then Terminator came out, I thought it was me. I watched Pain in Full and straight away I wanted a key. Like, look at me, now who's a G?
These days I'm trying to make a spend like I'm dead. I'm trying to make a spend like I'm dead. These days I'm trying to make a spend like I'm dead. Spend like I'm dead. Spend like I'm dead.
Soul, 30, that's the price of my ass. 30, that's the price of my clock. 30 pieces. Yeah, I'll do anything for that chance to escape that rat race. You could be a model with that face. You could be a producer with that bass. You could be an MC with those lines. There's a gold mine in your mind. I've been hypnotized by the hundreds, fantasizing about the thousands, mesmerized by the millions. I've got money on my mind. 30 pieces. Your nephew and your niece are on their knees for 30 pieces. We occupy the Middle East for 30 pieces. Yeah, that's what I got when I added it up. I know that it's not directly divisible, but the calculator was corrupt for the 30 pieces. Yeah, 30, that's the price of my art. 30, that's the price of my heart. 30, that's the price of my soul. 30 pieces made me lose control.